not through time, dear ones, but creating you in this eternal moment. This moment, dear ones, is all there is. This moment, dear ones, is all there has ever been. Yet your mind, out of fear, clings to an idea of who you think you are, based upon your past. Your mind seeks to control your future, to preserve and continually recreate this image that you think you are. You think you know yourself by knowing the past, and you think you know what the future will be based upon your knowledge of the past. Yet we tell you, dear ones, you are the direct experience. The direct experience of life which your mind can never contain, which your mind can never know. For your mind, dear one, exists within your experience, yet your experience exists beyond your mind. So, dear ones, you must find the freedom in yourself. You must realize that all fear is existing within you, that the world itself creates no fear. The world itself, dear ones, is a neutral place. The world itself is only form, empty manifestation, in which we choose to either project our own experience, our own feelings of this world onto the form, or in which we choose to surrender, to see the source of life and surrender into that source, knowing that all manifestation comes from this source, and experiencing this source, dear ones, within ourselves, within our consciousness, as love, as life, as who we truly are. This world, dear ones, is a projection of what you think you know. The forms themselves are God. They are not separate, yet you believe you see a separate world, separate from you, separate from God, disconnected from the oneness that is, disconnected, dear ones, from pure love, unconditional love. And you believe, dear ones, the world must be conquered. You believe, dear ones, the world must be controlled. You believe, dear ones, that you are separate and you must exert your will upon life. You must mold the world to meet your needs. And so, dear ones, you live inside your mind. You live in an image, thinking you understand, choosing to manipulate the world around you, and creating imbalance. Imbalancing the natural order, imbalancing the natural flow of awareness, the natural change of manifest forms. You choose to exert your will based upon the idea of a separate self, and you split apart this world. You disrupt the natural harmony. You disrupt, dear ones. You disrupt the flow of life. And now you find yourself in a world that is struggling to find balance. In a world, dear ones, that is trying to restore its equilibrium, that is trying to restore its balance to continue creating life. Yet through your selfish ideas, through your idea of separation, you continually manipulate the world, disabling it from finding natural balance within itself. You continually seek to change. Seek to improve the world based upon your limited understanding, and you push it further into imbalance. Look at your bodies, dear ones. Look at what your egoic sense of self has done to your physical bodies. Believing yourself to be separate, believing yourself to be disconnected, living in fear of that which you believe to be different from you, you have created disease. You have created cancers. You have created all sorts of manifest imbalance. For you are holding fear within yourself. And by holding fear within your mental field, you are not allowing your body to find its natural equilibrium. You are not allowing the flow of life to come and move within your cells. You are not allowing, dear ones, your body to self-heal. And yet, through all your experience, your egoic mind continues to believe that you know how to heal yourself, that you know how to create life, that you know how to restore balance. And so you try, viewing your body as separate, viewing all of life as separate, you try to manipulate the parts to restore wholeness. Yet you see, dear ones, your focus is upon the individual pieces. It is upon the understanding that all of life is separate. And when that you change one separate part, you create wholeness. How can this be so? This is an impossibility. Do you understand your mind's reasoning? Do you understand, dear ones, that your mind is not fit to create life? That your mind, dear ones, is not fit to continue living in the way it has? Your mind is based upon separation, an egoic sense of self that lives in fear of the world around you. A separate sense of self, dear ones, that is creating imbalance. Imbalance within your mind, fearing what you see. Imbalance within your body, fearing what you feel. Imbalance within this world, fearing what is created. You must have the strength, dear ones, the strength and the courage to be honest with yourself, to look at yourself from the place of awareness, to see what your mind believes, to see what you have been creating. You must be able, dear ones, to create the space, to see the space that exists between your awareness and your thinking mind. You must experience the space in which your mind exists. And then, dear ones, you will be able to see more clearly how your mind has been creating your reality, how your thoughts of separation, how the ideas you've adopted from others throughout your life is sculpting how you unconsciously react to the world around you. And all of your reactions, dear ones, are disconnected from love. All of your reactions, dear ones, are being created from fear, from the belief that you are separate, from the belief that you must change the natural world, from the belief that you, as an individual human being, can heal all the imbalance that exists through your control, through your desire to change, through your manipulation.